An electric pump that provides 30 kilowatts of shaft power is used to pump water from a lake to a higher reservoir. The free surface of the upper reservoir is 50 meters higher than that of the lake. If the flow rate of the water is 0.04 cubic meters per second, what is the mechanical power that is lost through thermal energy due to frictional effects? Pause here and try solving this problem yourself before watching the solution. This is the first example for the first law of thermodynamics 12-minute lecture video. The links to the other examples on this topic and the other lectures of the thermo course are found in the description below. Just like with the previous example and almost every system, control volume, or process we analyze in this course, we begin by selecting a control volume and writing the conservation of energy equation. Even though the aforementioned friction might cause the water to increase in temperature, and we'll soon learn how changes in temperature might change the internal energy of a substance, this temperature difference will most likely be negligible, so delta U is negligible as well. Depending on the inlet and exit areas, the inlet and exit velocities might be different, but again, we'll learn very soon that velocities in the same order of magnitude make little difference in terms of all the other energy changes. But more importantly, our control volume's boundaries are located on the free surface of the water bodies, so the velocities there are close to zero. So we'll assume this to be negligible as well. As for the change in potential energy, we have water coming in from the lake, which can be our datum, and water leaving 50 meters higher. We know that the energy change is mgz, but since we were given the power of the pump, and we're being asked to find the power lost as heat to friction, what we're looking at here is the change in energy per unit time. This means that we need to divide the conservation of energy equation by time to have all variables as rates of time. Because of this, the change in potential energy rate is basically the mass flow times g times z. The mass flow, as we learned in the main lecture, can be written as density times volumetric flow, both of which we were given. We have a rate of work coming in, no work coming out, no heat rate coming in, and we're looking to find the heat rate coming out of the system due to friction. We solve for this heat rate and we substitute the value for the rest of the variables. We make sure they are consistent by converting watts to kilowatts, and we find that the mechanical power lost to thermal energy due to friction is 10.38 kilowatts. If you want to check out the other examples for this topic, the main lecture video, or other lectures of the thermo course and other engineering courses, make sure to check out the links in the description below. Thanks for watching!